Hi students, welcome to the problem solving session on energy and power signal. Let us solve this problem. First question we will take and solve it. So in order to find whether the given signal is energy signal or power signal, we have to use the definition. What is the definition? A signal is energy signal if energy is finite, power is zero. A signal is power signal when power is finite. Power is finite and the energy must be infinite, right? So that's what energy must be infinite. So if you want to check whether a given signal is energy signal or power signal, I need both parameters. So I have to find both. First I find, then I apply the definition of this. Then from that I conclude whether the given signal is energy or power signal. Okay, what is the first one? First one is x of t is equal to a cos omega t plus theta, right? So I find energy. Energy is given by, what is the formula for a this is continuous time? Energy is given by limit t tends to infinity minus infinity to, minus t to plus t mod x of t whole square dt. X of t is given, substitute that t tends to infinity minus t2 plus t a cos squared a square omega t plus theta dt. I substitute x of t and squared it. Okay, then constant I take it outside, limit t tends to infinity, right? So cos squared I cannot integrate directly, so I write 1 plus cos 2 omega t by 2, that 2 I take outside, right? So cos square t I have written like this, cos 2 omega t, okay, plus theta, fine, plus theta dt, okay. So limit t tends to infinity a squared by 2 integral minus t2 plus t 1 into dt, I split the integration, minus t2 plus t cos 2 omega t plus theta, right, into dt. Fine, you see that this integration will be equal to 0. Why? It is cos 2, cos 2, cos wave I can write as, this is what my cos wave, one cos one, this is one hertz, second hertz I can write 2 cycles, right? So what is this integration? Integration is area under the curve, area under the curve of cos 2. This is what cos 2, I have to find the area. What is the area? You see, this positive is cancelled by this negative. Similarly, this negative area is cancelled by this positive area. So here total area is, area under the curve is 0. Similarly, you see this positive is cancelled by this negative, right? And this negative is cancelled by this positive. So here also area 0. So total area under the curve is 0. So neglect that. So it will become limit t tends to infinity a squared by 2, a squared by 2, integral 1, that is t minus t2 plus t. What will happen? That will be equal to limit t tends to infinity a squared by 2 into 2 into 2t. When limit t tends to infinity, what will happen? The answer will become infinity. So energy is infinity. So we found energy. Next we have to find power. What is power? Power is limit t tends to infinity 1 by 2t into e only. Yes or no? Why? You see, what is the formula for power? Power is given by limit t tends to infinity 1 by 2t minus integral to minus infinity plus infinity mod x of t squared into dt. What about this one? This is the formula for energy. yes or no. So I can write power is equal to, otherwise energy is the average of power. So energy per time is power, right? We know power is equal to energy per time. That's what I have done here, right? So T tends to infinity. So limit T tends to infinity 1 by 2 T. Already I found energy value. Energy value is given by this value. This is T tends to infinity. Before that, what is the answer? This integration is giving A squared by 2 into 2 T. The value of the integration is A squared by 2 into 2 T. So similarly, this value is what? A squared by 2 into 2 T. That we found. A squared by 2 into 2 T. This integration only we found. After substituting T tends to infinity, it will become infinity. This, it's not there. So what will happen? This 2t and this 2t will be there. So limit T tends to infinity, but that is a constant. We cannot substitute. So P is equal to A squared by 2. Right? So what is the answer we got? We got energy is infinity. Power is amplitude square by 2. So, energy is infinite, power is finite, so it must be a power signal. Simple. Okay, so easy to understand. What is the second problem? Second problem is x of t is equal to a sine omega t plus theta. For that also we get the same answer, because why? When you expand that, what will happen here? Instead of cos, 1 plus 1 minus will come. Again the answer will be 0. How can I see here? What is the only difference? Here we are having a squared. We will have a squared sine squared omega t plus theta will come. How can we express this? You will express as 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. So instead of plus, what you do? You will substitute 1 minus cos 2. Again, that cos integration will become 0. So you will get the same answer. So for the second problem also, the answer is E is infinity, P is finite. That is given by A squared by 2. Fine. So in general, in computer exam, if they give A instead of 5, don't need to go and do the integration directly. You put the answer directly. So if they give the question as x of t is equal to 4 sine omega t, some 45 degree, anything. So we know that sine and cos are power signal. So directly you can say E is equal to infinity. P is A square. A is 4. So 4 squared by 2 is 16. Directly you can write. If they give you instead of A, if they ask x of t 4 sine omega t plus theta in exam, you follow the same procedure and you will get 16 as the answer. Right? So what about third question? Third question is given by x of t is equal to e power minus 3t into u of t. Let us find the energy and the power. So what is energy? Energy is given by limit T tends to infinity, minus T to plus T mod x of t whole square dt. Right? So what is the thing? They gave x of t varies from my e power minus 3t into u of t. U of t has values from 0 to infinity only. Less than 0, it is 0. So the integral should go from 0 to, so I write in a different way. Here I take limit outside, limit, leave it, leave the limit. I substitute T is infinity. The integral varies from minus infinity to plus infinity, d squared t. Here integration with respect to t, but as per the problem, t varies from only 0 to infinity. Because less than 0, u of t will be 0. When you integrate it, the answer will be 0. When you multiply both, the answer will be 0. So you have to take t varies from 0 to infinity only. So I take the integration from 0 to infinity. What is my x of t? E power minus 3t. From 0 to infinity, what is u of t value? 1. Yes or no? When t value, what is u of t? U of t is equal to 1 when t is greater than 0. That means what? from 0 to infinity, t is greater than 0, 0 and above, up to infinity, u of t value 1. The integral varies from t is equal to 0 to infinity, up to 0 to infinity, u of t is 1. So, substitute that dt. So, if you simplify, what you get is as a square. So, 0 to infinity, e power minus 16 to dt. If you simplify, what you get is e power minus 60 by minus 6, 0 to infinity, right? If you substitute e power minus infinity by minus 6, minus e power minus 6 into 0 by minus 6, that will be equal to 1 by 6. This is finite number. So, energy is finite. Energy is 1 by 6. What is power? Power is given by limit t tends to infinity, 1 by t, 2t minus infinity, sorry, minus t to 2 plus t mod x of t whole square dt. This value we found, what is that? 1 by 6, limit t tends to infinity, 1 by 2t into 1 by 6. So, when t varies, t tends to infinity, 1 by infinity will become 0. So, anything by infinity, 0. So, power 0, energy is 1 by 6. So, this is energy signal. This one only I found in the steps. Yes or no? This is what the integration value is, 1 by 6. Okay. So, that's all about this session. If you have any doubt, please ask me in comment section. Thank you.